Well, howdy, 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 folks. Got two subjects today. One is what to do when your town has never had a vendor. They don't know what to do with a vendor, and they don't even have rules and codes, and they just are freaking out, right? And then another question that came in was, what can I expect with the health department inspector who comes and checks me out to approve me for the first time? And then what is it called? The later times. It's subsequential or sub, I don't know the word. All right. So here's the deal. You might be a redneck if you can't pronounce your words. We've got, hey, Amanda, glad you're here. So let's talk first. I'm going to read this to you because this came in from somebody on the Facebook page. Michael asks, good morning, Ben. I spoke to my county health department and they have heard of hot dog carts, but do not have any in the county. My question is, how do I help them understand what a mobile hot dog cart is and how it works? They are talking about bathrooms and I need to tell them every place I vend or cater, public or private. Now, a couple things wrong with that or with their logic there. This is they're going, oh my gosh, how will we know where he is? Well, how do you know where the Pizza Hut delivery driver is? And he's carrying food to the public and he could have chicken shit in his car seats. So does the Pizza Hut drivers all call in and tell you what deliveries they're making that day? Every time they're making one, and does Uber Eats call and tell you every time they're making a delivery of food? Probably not. So probably don't have to tell the health department where your cart's going to be located, especially for private vending. Right. And here's how you can tell. Here's a way to double check this. You will have more than likely in your town caterers. Okay. Mostly probably through restaurants in your town. So ask your health department or whoever's telling you this nonsense, ask them, Michael, say, so if I have a Pizza Hut and I cater, does Pizza Hut call you every time they go to a delivery or to a catering gig? Oh, they don't. Then you can't require it of me. Because then it is discriminatory codes and it would be illegal. So they cannot discriminate and create separate codes for the same food service, basically. So they can, however, ask you where you're going to be vending. And this is why I teach in my basic training, play it down. When you approach them, don't talk about, man, Mr. Health Inspector, you're not going to believe this, but I'm going to have 20 carts by the end of the week. I'm going to have carts all over the city. You're going to love it. Well, here's what you got to keep in mind. These are state employees, even though they work through the county. Okay. They're state employees. Typically some of them are paid by the county, blah, 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 but they follow state codes. So as the state health department who is inspecting you through your county health department, they get paid a salary, right? Let's say that's $1,000 a week. That's their salary. I'm just making the number up. So they have a zone that is their restaurant area. They have to cover all the restaurants and food establishments in that area. You come along. Does their pay go up? No, their pay doesn't go up. So they immediately, and many we find do this. We've even recorded some that do it. I did a show one time where I made several calls to health departments and asked questions and we checked how they responded. Some of them respond very, they try to deter you. They try to deter you from doing the business. Oh, you'll never make it. It's a bad area to do this. You don't want to do this. I mean, this, you'd rather go dig ditches or something. Go work at McDonald's, man. Don't do this. They discourage you. So we recorded some of those. It was funny as hell. But the bottom line is if you will play it down, and here's how you play it down. We're thinking about opening a food cart, an open cart, like a hot dog cart, doing some catering, maybe some parties. Don't know how often we'll do it. Because here's the deal. Whether you do it once a year or whether you do it 900 times a day, it's the same license. So you get a health department permit to work in your state. So and in most states, that's how it is. Okay. There's a couple states that are wonky and you have to get a state health department permit for each county that you might be working in. But ignore that because it's very seldom. So here's the deal. you would then, you would play it down. Then you would talk to them. Anything they tell you, get in writing. I have an article called learnhotdogs.com/liar. And I know that sounds strong, but the point is it will tell you what to do and how to suss out the truth when you hear something erroneous, or ignorant, as you need to tell them everywhere you're catering, even private. No, you don't. If they're not requiring that of the restaurants, which they ain't, then they can't require it of you. And if it's in the code and it's discriminatory, well, they've just set themselves up for a federal lawsuit, because that would be illegal. That'd violate the law. Anytime a city, county, or state government creates a code that is restrictive and discriminatory in its wording against a certain segment of business, it violates federal law. So I'm not saying all this to scare you. I'm saying that this health inspector or whoever you talk to, Michael, is wrong. Okay? They're wrong, wrong, wrong. But helping educate them often helps. Okay? Sometimes you can tell them, oh, well, I called the state and do this first. Call the state and go, what's the, you know, I want to run a cart. I'm going to be in this county. They don't seem to know what's going on, or no, they've never had a vendor. Can you give me the ins and outs real, you know, briefly? Well, they work for us. They're paid for by our tax dollars. They should be more than happy to help you. And typically I found the people at the state are more apt and more well-meaning at the state level than they are at the county, because you have just added more work to the county employee without paying him more money or her. So we have two in North Carolina. One did something so horrible the other day, he's going to lose his job over it. In North Carolina, he actually wrote the vendor and said, you don't want to do this. You don't want to do, I mean, just horribly negative. I submitted that evidence from the vendor to the state. The state called me and said, please don't sue us. We are going to reprimand him. Well, apparently he bowed up at them for whatever reason, and he's being terminated. So things like that happen. And it usually just takes a phone call. So I have something else for you too, though. And I'm going to put the link here for you. Okay. In this, let me get back over here to the video. And happy Friday, by the way. I'm glad it's Friday. I've got chickens to tend to. I got stuff to do. All right. So that's why I'm doing this a little early today. I'm going to put this link in here. If you go to this link, on this link is a PDF that you can download and print or just email to somebody like your health inspector. And it's all the positives about vending based on not just Ben, not me going, vending's great. It'll really help your town out. No, this is based on science, basically a 20 something year study where they took safety records and found out the safest streets in towns and cities across America were those ones with vendors. They also showed the other benefits of having vendors, how the public felt safer. It's a cool case study. Okay. And it's written by lawyers. So that's even better. And we all know how smart lawyers are. So that will help you a lot there. Now, somebody else, and I'm going to get to your comments on here too. So don't think I'm ignoring them. I see them coming up now. Let me go to another. I hope that answers your question, Michael. The other one I got was what to expect. Shelly goes, what does health inspector look for upon inspection of your cart before getting started? Typically, the before getting started is like the least one to worry about. And I'll tell you why real quickly. When you're working, sometimes you got a rag here that you should have had in your sanitization solution, or you set a pair of tongs down in the wrong spot and they walk up on you and you go, crap, and they mark you off a point for it and you made a 99 instead of 100, right? And not a big deal. But a lot of people worry about that first inspection. Well, I want you to remember this. When you go for your first inspection, where they're inspecting your cart or equipment, your trailer, whatever you've got, it can be nerve-wracking because this is a state official, right? Well, that person, man or woman, got up that morning, and if they have two legs, they put on their pants one leg at a time, just like you do. And so they're just normal human beings. You know, they watch Netflix, with or without the chilling. They do things, you know, like we do. They eat at places, they laugh, they go see family. They're human beings, right? That's my point. These are people that, yes, they have a higher status maybe as far as authority, but they're not like gods. They're humans. And so they'll show up, and typically they just want to walk around the cart and make sure that there's nothing obvious. Like, you don't have your cat food in your cooler because your cat Mincy loves to keep her, she likes her vittles cooler or colder. They're going to check the obvious things. Typically, they'll walk around it. Sometimes they don't even have you turn it on. Sometimes they will have you turn it on. They'll go, you don't have to turn on the steam table. I've never had one ask for the steam table to be turned on. But they'll ask, can you run the hot water? I want to see that it works. Okay, sure. Click hot water. Because it's instant. You know, most carts nowadays, it's instant hot water. As soon as you turn it on, you got hot water. Then they'll make sure, do you have your thermometer in your cooler? All right. Do you have a thermometer to check your meat temp? Yeah, I do. And do you have extras of anything? If you want to know the things to have, it's always to have doubles of everything. I like redundancy, right? If I drop my tongs, I don't want to have to go, hold on, sir. Give me just a second. Go around to the side of my cart and wash the tongs I just dropped on the ground and then use them, because all he's going to see in his head is that those tongs on the ground. So I always have extra things. If I drop a rag, I got new rags. If I drop tongs, I got new tongs. And that way I've got replacements that are fresh and clean in a Ziploc bag or a Ziploc tote container or something like that. That's the way to do that, so that you don't have an issue with scaring your customer, and it will impress the health inspector. So your health inspector will typically just walk around the cart, make you check the water sometimes, and they'll make sure that the top, let's say you built your own cart, they'll make sure if it's wooden top, they'll make sure you put the ceiling over it. They might check if you have a grill, they might check and say, hey, are you going to be using an umbrella? Can I see it? Typically, though, they won't. I talk to literally thousands of vendors every year, and it's rare that I hear of anything that's just wackadoo. I have had one vendor in 9 years where the health inspector wanted him to heat up water to 143 degrees in his steam table before he'd leave. He wanted water heated up, and which didn't make sense because this vendor was steaming, so all he had to do is put a little bit of water in the bottom of the pan, perforated pan on top of that, and create a steam, which takes 212 degrees to create a steam. But that doesn't tell you anything about the product temp because he didn't have any product there. They'll never ask you to, like, hey, bring your products and set up just like you would if you're open. They're not going to do that. They can't, like, inconvenience you or cost you extra money. They're inspecting equipment and equipment alone. So don't worry about it. Everybody does it. Everybody that's vending legally has had it done. Some of them walk up and just walk around it and go, looks good. Nice cart. All right. See you later. No joke. I get more of those where somebody who's been nervous calls me and goes, Ben, I was nervous for nothing. And typically that's the deal. Okay. Now I'm going to pull up your questions. That's all I had for you today. And then I'll pull up your stuff and see. Double T, glad you're here. Nick Dice. Thanks for being here. Cheryl Hager. I love you too. And let's see. That is the truth, Ben. Dragon Wieners. That's Amanda with Dragon Wieners. She starts the 16th. That's her. She made herself. She drew a line in the sand and said, I'm starting this date. And she's almost to start. And we're going to get to see it. So Veronica says, thanks so much for all this information. You were awesome. You see, you're going to make my head big, Veronica. You're going to make my head swell up. I won't even be able to get in the door at the house. I'm at Birmingham, Alabama next week. I start my sale, Noah Hot Dogs. I like that, Noah. I'd like to know what it means or stands for, because when I hear Noah like that, Noah, it's like the National Oceanographic Administration, Atmospheric Administration. You know, the people that do the hurricane stuff. But I like that. Noah, hot dogs. Wish me good. I'm ready. Muchas gracias. I say de nada. Viva Mexico. I like it. Awesome, Veronica. I wish you well. Please send us pictures. On day one, when you get set up, snap a selfie in front of your cart or trailer, whatever you're using. We want to see it, okay? I'll share it on here. Cheryl is almost ready. Awesome, Cheryl. Let's see. That link is dead. I don't know why that link is dead. Let me see. I'm going to check this link. All right. I'm going to sit. Yeah, it didn't open, did it? Okay, then something's wrong there. Let's try this. Command C. I apologize, but thanks for pointing it out because that would have ticked me off. This should, let me see if this works. Tell me if that works. I think it's shortening my link and making it not work. Here's the cool thing though. I put it in the video comments already. So in the video comments, you'll have the link, to what this is. I already put it in there, but, I apologize if this one's not working, for whatever reason. No, she says. It's very popular Mexican song in Spanish. Noah Noah. Okay, I'm going to listen to that. I'm going to Google it after we get done. All right. So let me see if I can try this for you. Watch this. I'm going to use Google Shortener. I don't know if y'all know about it, but you can go to goo.gl. Type in a long, you know, let's say you're giving your buddy an Amazon link and it's 9,000 characters long. You can go to goo.gl and put that link in there and it shortens it. And that's what I'm fixing to do for you right here. And I'm going to hook you up with this. See if that one works. Maybe it does. Okay. So let's see. No, I'm going to look that up for sure. All right. I hope y'all have a fantastic weekend. I don't know if I'll be on here tomorrow. Still ask questions. It depends on how many questions I get. If I get too many, then I get overwhelmed and I feel like, oh my gosh, I got to answer these before it gets too many. Paid my fees to the state, waiting for final inspection. Hope to start selling next week. Wheat Street Dogs. I like that. Wheat Street Dogs. First time I've heard that one. Thanks for all the info, Pat. You're welcome. Thank you for being here and I wish you well. Keep us up to date on it. Double T, it's YouTube. 9 times out of 10, the links put in the comments get messed up. I appreciate that, Double T. I didn't realize that. Cheryl, you're welcome. I thank y'all. I'm not going to drag this out, but y'all have a good weekend. I love you. Talk to you later.